Hi everyone.
Rupert here. It's been a while, and welcome to a new series that I've started. That is basically going to be a coach tour of promods. So what we're going to be doing is taking this coach that I've skinned myself. So it's a Webley's executive coach travel, which is what I've made up. And basically what we're going to do is we're just going to tour promods in this coach. And I will take destination suggestions, so please do leave your comments. But our first destination will be Iceland, and we're going to make a big tour of this and go down all the little roads, and it's going to be quite exciting. And we're basically just going to take in promods and all of its all of the scenery and all of that good stuff, and we're going to be just having a great drive on the way in our coach. So our first destination is Carlisle. Now, the reason I'm starting in Cardiff, which is my home base, and we're going to go to Carlisle, and we're going to go into the bus station there, and that would be about the right length for this video. So that would just be the sort of the first leg towards Thurso, which we will then carry on to Iceland. So we might as well get on with our first leg of the journey. We're going to be pretending that the passengers have already boarded on the coach. This is a Volvo B12B TX, and quite an old coach, but it certainly is a lovely, lovely coach to drive. So yeah, it is a left-hand drive, and so I'm not quite used to this, but it should be good fun. Just check the brakes working. Yes, they are. Right, lovely. Let's start the engine. Lovely jubbly. Right, it's quite a nice sounding engine. I think that's the right level. Quite a lovely roar to it. Certainly sounds like a real coach. Put her into gear. We'll just check that the gearbox are in the right setting. Hang on. Because I had been driving a different type of Volvo before. So we'll just check that that's in the... no, it's not right. So let's put it into range, I believe we want it in for this coach. Got 8 gears, so we've got 1 through 6, and then we put it into the next range, and we've got 7 and 8. Not sure whether we'll need that other range, but let's just get going, I think. Steering's okay? Yes, it is. Right, let's go. Might help if we release the brake. Right, off we go then. Quite different to driving a lorry, because they're so much longer. Yes, there's no articulation, but they're so much longer that you just have to take that into account. So we are going to... Oh, that's a bit close. There we go. Okay, so we're going left here. Just check what's coming. A bit difficult to see, that's the only trouble. Lovely bit of bouncing going along from the suspension, with this extra overhang as well. Alright, let's go. So we've got a red light here, and then we'll be going straight on, so we might want to get into that right hand lane as soon as these go green. Once the traffic permits that. But yes, so this mod is, well, I will put a link to it, but I have modified it heavily. So like I've changed the blind, so it's just a black blind. I've skinned it up, put decals on the window and all that good stuff, changed the sound, but I will send you a link to the original mod. It's a very good mod, I do love it, and I've been looking for a coach for this game for absolutely ages, and as you can tell, I'm quite excited to just drive it really. I just love, look at that, pretty nice. But anyway, wait for these lights to go green, and then we'll be on our way. Okay, let's not go. Looking forward to promods when we have the slightly more organised junctions. Come on, go before it goes red, please. I'm going. I'm not waiting for that. Okay. Maybe let it rev a little bit high there, but oh well. So our first bit of the journey is going to be on back roads, I believe, which will be quite nice. Just sort of going through the countryside. And being a coach, our speed limit for these sorts of roads is, well, at the moment it's 30, which I didn't notice. But on these roads, it's around about 50 miles per hour, which is 80 kilometres in this coach. And that's just because we're over 12 metres long. And in the UK that is the regulation. And on the motorways we'll be allowed to go up to 100 kilometres per hour, If our coach was slightly shorter, if it was under 12 metres, then we would be allowed to go 70, which is 120 or so. But because we're over 12 metres, we have to go 60, which, as I said, is 100. Well, it's just under 100 technically. It's 95, but we'll call it 100, I think. But yeah, so I do love coaches, just the amount they... Because we're quite low to the ground in a way, which makes it feel a little... You feel a little more connected with the road. And they just bounce around so much over the motorway. Don't think we're going to be joining that today. That's the M4, I believe. The thing that's really going to hold us up on this journey is the other traffic, really. The other truck traffic. Obviously, they've got a slower speed limit than us. Of course, it does display 40 on the GPS, but that's just because, you know, it's not a coach simulator after all. It is Euro Truck. And obviously, I can't actually pick up real passengers, but I do have an imagination, so I can pretend. That's what I love about simulators in general, is you can just imagine anything, really, and change the game to be however you want, really. Right, looks like we are going left up ahead then. Got the Araf sign on the road, because obviously we are in Wales currently. Right, so let's make a left here. Coach is turning in. Yep, it's clear. This is actually a Volvo sound mod. I will also link this mod up, which I really do love. This is one of my favourite sound mods I've ever heard. It just sounds so realistic, because under load it adds this lovely sort of coarse sound whereas if I put the clutch in, you don't really hear that lovely coarse sound, but in here it's quite chuggy in a way, but it sounds very realistic, because I go on a coach to school. And it certainly does sound very true to this. Now, I'm not sure if we're going to need 7 and 8 on these sorts of roads. We certainly won't for now. But we'll see if we do later on. Okay. What's the time currently in-game? It's about 3 o'clock. So we should arrive, I would say, about 9 o'clock in-game time, I think. But we'll have to see. I wonder if there's a train coming today. I'll have to get used to the gearing in this coach. It's a bit more like a car, really, because the first six gears are what you mainly use, really. But they are quite close together, the ratios. It's a little bit different. I'd love to see some UK trains added into this game, because that's certainly not a UK one. They're more found in, those type are more found in Germany and Austria and whatever. Oh, come along, let's go. My passengers don't want to be messed around with. I wonder what it'd be like to be a coach driver in real life. It'd be quite an interesting job, because you'd just get to see so many places. But equally, you'd have to look after all your passengers, which would be quite a job, I can imagine, sometimes. Especially being a coach driver for elderly people, because, you know, they are prone to running off, or more waddling off, anyway. But yeah, certainly it'd be an interesting job. It's always interesting, you always wonder what coach drivers actually do when they go on a big coach tour, because the coach drivers don't tend to go to all the different places themselves. So say they went to, I don't know, Austria and dropped off some people to go on a walk. I wonder what the coach driver would do, whether he'd just go off down to a cafe and sit in there all day, or, I don't know, let me know if you know. If you know any coach drivers, that'd be great. Love to hear it from them firsthand. Because to me it certainly sounds like a very desirable job to actually have. I'm not sure what the pay is like, but I don't think that matters. jolly good fun, I think. So, stuck behind a lorry. That's typical, isn't it? Take this time to admire the coach. Just look at it. It is such a beast. I love how big they are. Because coaches are so big without any articulation. They're just a big solid box, if you know what I mean. Maybe I'm just mad, but I do like them a lot. I just like the way they sort of swing around the corners as well. It's pretty fun. Fun things to drive. Right, righty ho then. So where are we going here? We're going straight on. I believe there's another junction after the one we're coming up to. Hopefully these trucks will turn off and then we'll be able to hit the open road and get to our destination on schedule. Basically, we're going to aim to get there before 10 o'clock at night, because we don't really want to be driving through the night with our passengers. They'd rather be in a hotel, I can imagine. So they will stay the night in Carlisle and maybe spend the next day there, and then in the morning we will then head up north to Thurso and maybe stop off at Inverness, because I know there's quite a nice hotel there that we can stop off at and perhaps see the Loch Ness Monster. So, but yes, like I said, just send in if you, because I haven't explored the whole of Promods because it's just massive. But if there's anywhere in particular you know is quite an interesting place to visit, if there are any Easter eggs or anything that you think I should show to you all, then please do comment below or send me a direct message through my Facebook page, which you can have a look if you didn't know I had that. I will link it up in the description. So send me a message or on Twitter, or just in the comments, like I said, or an email, whatever. But just send me interesting places to visit in Promods and I will drive there. And you will see the whole lot. I'm not going to quick travel anywhere. You will see me see the whole journey. It's going to be a big series. Yeah, it is, because we've got a lot of miles to cover in this coach. But I think it's going to be fun. Oh, see, I'm not used to driving a left-hand drive, so forgive me. It'll be interesting to see as well, because this coach, I bought this coach just before I started recording, because though I had it before, because I disabled the mod and whatever, it disappeared. So I thought, buy a new one, and we'll see how many miles it clocks up. I think it says 75 currently. It's a little bit small. I don't know if you can have a bigger display. No, it doesn't look like you can. No. I think it's 77 miles. We'll see. Seem to get stopped at all the level crossings today. See if we can do it so we don't have to stop. Now that's an interesting thing, actually. What is it about stopping at traffic lights or level crossings or whatever? Why don't people want to stop? Because it's not really a problem, is it? You just set off naturally. But why do you always try and just keep going when you get to traffic lights? Because there's something very annoying about stopping and then they go green. Something distinctly irritating, but what is it? Because it's not really a problem, is it? It doesn't take that much longer. You just drop the clutch in and off you go. So what is it that people don't like? I mean, I don't like it myself, and I don't know what it is. Which is quite an interesting thought, really. So we are stuck behind this polar fish truck. I wonder what type it is. It's a Scania by the looks of the mirror. Yeah, it's a Scania, I think. Is it Scania? It's quite difficult to see. I think it is. Nice speed up, considering he's in the beast of the road. Very well. Don't want to get too close, because if we have to brake, we don't really want all our passengers coming flying through the windscreen. So I can imagine it. Oh no, that's a Renault. Good grief. Sorry, everyone. That's quite a mistake to make. Yeah, I can imagine these windscreens are rather expensive to replace. With our lovely Weberly's decals, it, you can see, painted on the glass. Executive coach transport. I spent hours making this skin and just modifying the mod in general, which it says you're not supposed to do, but I see it as personal use, so I don't see it as a problem. That's how I always read those things on mods. As long as you're not redistributing it, which I won't, so don't ask me for this mod. I won't, because it says in the description of the mod and in all the readmes and whatever. Please do not edit or re-upload or whatever. So I'm not going to. So I will respect what the author wants. But yeah, so I see it. As long as I'm not actually using it, redistributing it with my modifications, it's fine. Which I won't, so it's not a problem. But yeah. If you want to simulate this coach that I've got currently, what you've got to do is change a bucket load of textures, because of the default floor textures are pretty grim. They look like a public convenience. And you've got to change the blind, because by default it has all these weird pictures, which are quite strange, I have to confess. And I just replaced it with a picture of my blinds. So if you look closely, there are actually the weaving details. What else did I change? I added custom decals on the windscreen, but that was something your... A template comes with the mod and instructions on how to do it, I think. What else did I change? Trying to think now. I changed the sound, and as I said, you can get the sound pack that I will link up in the description. It's just a Volvo one. You do have to modify it a bit to work with this coach, but I literally did it seconds before I started recording, and it didn't take more than a minute, presuming you extract the mod properly. But yeah, all of the modifications I've made are completely doable. Don't think there's anything else. Yeah, I think that's everything. Oh, and because it's an Iranian bus, technically, the mod comes with some Iranian number plates as an add-on, so you just turn them on. But what I've done, a little bit sneakily, is I've actually just painted some British number plates onto the paint job, so that they all line up, so you can see the one on the back and the one on the front. They don't look bad, actually. I downloaded a UK number plate font, so it looks perfectly acceptable. So yeah, so I'm a little bit of a perfectionist, so you know, all the details have to be there. What else did I change? I don't think I changed anything else. I was considering changing the seat textures. There's a load of... It's such a good mod, because you can change, like, the ceiling textures and whatever, like you could in a real coach when you're customising it. And you can change, like, the leather. But yeah, I was considering changing the seat textures just to something else. I mean, there's nothing wrong with these red seats. I just thought it'd be quite nice to have my own custom one that I might do for a later video. But, yeah, the red ones are fine, like you can see here. Oh, no, not that one. Oh dear, we'll get that. There we go. Nope, you can see. But anyway, I'd better get back in the cab. Otherwise, I think it'll go wrong. So, joining the M53 now. Can really open up the taps. This is where it's going to be a bit nasty, because it's going to be quite difficult to see out that window. Don't like that. Clear. Let's go. Fair bit of power in this coach, actually. It's 420 brake horsepower, which is a considerable amount for a coach. I would like to see if they're actually this high in most coaches. I mean, this is a very good mod, so I don't doubt that there is actually this configuration available in this particular coach. But I'd like to see how many other coaches, like Scanias or whatever, how much they usually have. I mean, this is a Euro 3 engine, I believe, in this particular coach, so it's not very efficient, because it's an older coach. It's just quite nice to drive, really. But it does look very posh, actually. Because posh coaches don't have to be new, as long as they're looked after properly and have been equipped with all the latest stuff. Let's overtake this lorry now. Oh, I tell you what, I've left the limiter on. That's what I've done. I knew I'd miss out something. Let's just quickly turn that off. Doopy doopy doo. Where is it? Truck speed limiter. Turn that off. That's good. Right, there we go. There we go. Get past this coat. This truck. We'll just set it to 60 because why not? I don't know why I've got the cruise control set in miles per hour on the dial. Oh, I better put my lights on before I get told off. Not quite sure why this cruise control is in miles per hour, but the dial is in kilometres. But you know, I must have forgotten to change that setting as well. do that for the next episode. That was quite handy in the UK, to be honest with you. Right, we're going to Carlisle, so I believe we need to go straight on here. Do we? Yeah, probably. Not sure how far we've got to go. We can just check on the GPS, the other one. 134 miles. That's not very far. We'll do that in literally no time at all, because we're going quite quick. So that's fine. Right, what lane do we need to be in? I believe we need to stay in this one. Alright, we're probably going to change into the left one, I would assume. Yeah. Certainly don't want to be going to the south. Otherwise we'd end up where we started. Not sure what motorway we're joining. Got a sign here that says... What is it? The M6. Oh, okay, right. We're on the M6 then. I just got a little bit disorientated. But, yeah, if we're on the M6, that's fine. I know where I am now. I was tempted to stop at Liverpool, but... Might as well make a little bit of progress, otherwise we'd have quite a lot to do in the next video to get to Thurso. But like I said, we'll stop at a hotel in Inverness, because I know there's quite a nice one near the Loch Ness, and we can pretend that the people on the coach trip are then going to go to the Loch Ness and spend the day there. So after all, Scotland is a beautiful place. Oh, I believe we're going to stay in this lane. Oh, looks like a bit of a kerfuffle potentially with all these trucks and cars changing lanes. Got to be prepared, because you know what the Euro Truck AI is like. Last minute lane changing. Bet someone's going to pull out on me. Yep, you are, aren't you? You are going to pull out. Are you going to pull out? No, you're not. Thank you very much. That was very kind of you. Okay. Just a bit of a cruise now then. Up to wherever we're going. What's going on here then? Oh dear. We'll just have to stop, I think. This is my... Look! They've had a crash. That's quite amusing, actually. What are you doing? Don't reverse on a motorway. Wow. What's going on here? What is going on? Let's check behind me. Don't know if there's a car. What's going on? Just... Wow. Lovely AI here. Get a move on. Come along, let's go. Well, we didn't hit anything, so that's a plus, I suppose. At this moment, something pulls out, and I go straight into the side of it. AI madness. Good fun, though. Worryingly true to real life. Anyway, let's see if we can get make a little bit of time up. If you can go past, and I will change into your lane. Oh, don't slam your brakes on, thank you. A little bit variable their speed there, and they sometimes change when changing onto different road sections. Right then. Bit of a bend on a motorway, good grief. I think the designer of this motorway had a bit of a sneeze when he was drawing it out. Okay. Looks like we're going to be going past some cars as well. Who would have thought it? Thank you, Mr. Range Rover. Just pull out. Now, wow. Now you're just going to brake, aren't you? Yeah, I suppose it's a speed limit, but it's not particularly helpful for me if you just pull out and then slam your brakes on. But hey, it's what drivers are like in real life, so you've got to deal with it, really. Sit in his boot now. Nope, he's going to really slow down. Oh no, let's go 40 miles per hour on a motorway. That is a perfectly acceptable thing to do. Oh, it is great, the AI, isn't it? let's get a move on now. Come along, look, the speed limit's raised. And now you're on... Don't you dare come up the inside of me, because I'm not... just ram you. No, I wouldn't really, because I wouldn't want to scratch the paintwork. Plus there's too much paperwork as well. And the passengers wouldn't be impressed either, I doubt. Apart from that, it's a great idea. Just let some people past. They're probably stuck behind me. No, apparently not. Well, this is Euro Truck, where AI fly around tight bends and poodle along the motorway. Adds to the fun, though, doesn't it? Keeps you on your toes, anyway. One of these is going to pull out, I can tell. Which one is it going to be? It's not the van. Is it going to be the coach? It's not the coach. And the truck just pulls out for no reason whatsoever. Oh, look, it's a good old Scania. Getting overtaken by a Volvo. Must be so angry. That's a coach, slightly different thing, really. I can just imagine all the passengers in the back waving to the truck drivers like they do. Alright, okay, we're going to be going into the right-hand lane to carry on the M6. Okay, straight on at this junction, and sign us to Kendal. Now, I have very pleasant experience of Kendal. I remember I went there once when I was slightly younger. Parked in a multi-storey car park. Went up the stairwell, and I was nearly sick because it stank so bad. It was actually awful. I think it was the worst thing I've ever smelled in my life. And I was genuinely nearly sick. So that's a pleasant story. So I have very positive experiences of Kendal. I'm sure it's a lovely place, really. But yes, my impressions are somewhat blackened by that moment. Okay. I do love how AI cars, they will happily speed along the motorway, but as soon as you get into a speed limit zone, they will just sit at 45. It's interesting, actually, because from what I've seen, the cars on the... do you call that the outside lane? I can't remember. I think that's the inside lane for some reason. They sit at about 45-ish. People in the middle lane tend to sit around about the speed limit. And people in the outside lane, which I believe is the... Oh, I don't know. It's I know it's just wrong, whatever the... however it's named. But anyway, people into the lane to the right, anyway, they sit at around about 55. So I think what it does is it takes a percentage of the speed limit and then whatever lane the car is in is what... what speed they'll go. It's like I'm sitting behind this vehicle quite happily. And why is he flashing his right indicator? That's a bit weird. And he's just going along at this speed quite happily. Whereas the coaches, I reckon they're doing about 45. One day I will test my hypothesis to check if it's right. When I've got lots of time to kill. Right, Mr. Coach, please let me in. Oh, I could probably do him, put my foot down, couldn't I? Just thank him for letting me in, even though he probably didn't really. Oh, it looks like we're arriving in Carlisle then. We'll stay behind this truck. The Volvo's on the back. I wonder if it's a Volvo truck pulling them, or whether it's a Scania just to rub it in. Probably is. Let me have a look. Oh no, he's just going to whip it into... oh, it's a DAF. He's going to whip it into the middle lane. There's no tomorrow. I better not undertake him, and I really... I'll just sit here on his inside. That's a much better plan. Okay, let's make a left at the bottom of this slip. Wait, oh, it's a bit wobbly. That's what I love about coaches. They're so big. So let's check if there's actually anything coming. Oh, yes, there is. There we go. The only trouble with having the gear lever on the right is, because of the way I have my steering wheel configured, the buttons that change the view are on the right hand side of the steering wheel. So when I'm changing gear, I can't change the view very easily. It's a little bit of an inconvenience, but nothing that can't be dealt with. So 11 miles to go, we're just here now. So we're going to make a left, and then we're going to be parking up in the bus station. And yes, we have met our target of arriving. I did say we'd be around about 9 o'clock, so that was a pretty good guess. And we're certainly here before 10, which is nice. But the passengers will be able to go for their dinner, and then head off to sleep. And here we are then, arriving in Carlisle. Better visit Carlisle Castle while we're here. I don't know if that's simulated. I'll have to have a look. Alright, make a left here then. Fourth will do. Yep, fourth will do. That way. Right, so here we are then. Arriving in Carlisle. Not too late. We've got an interior light, look at that. I love that, because it turns on the interior ones. Hang on, let's see if we can do it without crashing. But that turns the interior lights on. So good. Right, oh, red light now. We can play with the interior light at the red light. That'd be fun, right? Right, yeah, now what we've got? We've got an interior light. See? A bit better when it's completely dark, when no street lamp. You can see it outside as well, look. Look at that. Very posh. And on the back, what we have is brake lights and indicators. It's quite smart. Can't imagine that would have been cheap. Let's try not to curb it. There we go. Okay. So where's the bus stop then? We need to get in that lane. That's the garage. And we are making a right and then a left, so that'd be nice. Right. Oh, there we go. I knew I'd do that at some point. Okay, here we are then. Right, let's turn in here. Take this bay here, shall we? Yeah, let's take this bay here. Keep it nice and tight to that curb so we can swing it in here. Yeah, there we go. Oh, done that twice now. Okay, actually, that's not a very clever thing to do, is it? Because the door's on that side. So that's a bit mean to our passengers. I wonder if there's any other bays that we could go in. Oh yes, there is. There's one around there. That'd be a bit better. That's the trouble with being in the UK with a foreign coach. The door's on the wrong side, so it's a little bit dangerous. Let's see if we can get nice and close to that curb. Without curbing it, preferably. Lovely javelin. Okay, straighten up a bit, so it looks a little bit better. That'll do. Turn the coach off. Pretend they were letting the passengers out. Oh look, I left the door right by the sign. Oh well. Okay, well here we are in Carlisle then. On the next leg of our journey, we will, I'll just turn the interior light on just so you can see it. There you go, look. Nice. Okay, on the next leg of our journey, we will head up to Thurso, which is 300 miles. So it's about the same as it was today. And we'll get to go down some lovely Scottish roads. And then we will be heading straight up via the Faroe Islands. And I know there's a bus stop here, so we'll stop there. And we will basically, I think what we'll do is pretty much that. We'll do a bit of a figure of eight, which will be a long journey, yes, but it'll be very good fun. And then maybe we'll head up here. And then just basically round the edge of the map. And I might install Rust Map at some point. And definitely explore some of France, because I haven't actually had a look at that. Because in the previous update, it was crashing. So if your promods was crashing, that's probably why. Just get the latest update, and it seems to be fixed. But yes, I hope you enjoyed that, everyone. The first of the Webberly Tours series. I aim to be getting out a spin tires video relatively soon. So yeah, you can look out for that as well if you enjoy spin tires. But other than that, hope you enjoyed the video. And from myself and all at Webberly Tours, take care, and I'll see you soon.